Valder, it's Barb.
Thank you so much, Ms. Barb Dean, for joining us here in Dallas, Texas on the Valder Beebe Show.
Valder, I adore you. How are you, honey?
I adore you also, too, and I love the work that you do. What are you up to today?
Well, today I'm talking about long-acting reversible contraception.
Good day. Thank you for joining me here live in Dallas, Texas on the Valder Beebe Show. Who do I have with me?
Hi, this is Marti Moore.
Well, Marti Moore, hi. It's cold and flu season. What can you help us to tell us to kind of weather the storm, as they say?
So here's what's important. One of the things is that you have to be ready with your flu vaccination. It's absolutely critical that you think about what you're doing. And one of the most important things is you've got to do the flu fighter. You've got to get your immune system. And there's a great area for you to go. It's curad.com, to where you can look at your lifestyle and figure out what you can do to prevent.
Okay. What happens if you don't get a flu shot? Because I know many people who do not do that.
Yeah, I highly, highly recommend it. And last year there was a lot of conversation that occurred about the flu vaccination. And what happened was that the viruses itself actually mutated. This year, here's what we know. It's spot on. And so we're seeing influenza A with substrains of H1N1 and H2N3 and influenza B. And so I encourage flu vaccinations. I know there are people who, for personal reasons, choose not to. They're going to have to be incredibly careful because H1N1, we know it from when 2009, it did not actually infect those that you usually think, the very young or the very old. It actually was very virulent in around the 30s and 40s and 50-year-olds and pregnant women. Very severe respiratory diseases. So it's really important for people to be conscious about what they're doing if they choose not to do the vaccination.
Good advice. We needed to speak to that audience also. So if you do get the flu vaccine, that's one of the defenses. Anything else we need?
Oh, there's so many that you need to be doing. And of course, one of them is hand hygiene. And I really try to talk to people about doing good hand hygiene. I call this the no zone. So you don't want to touch your eyes, your nose, and your lips. And remember, viruses travel either by droplets in the air or inanimate objects. And so you have to be thinking about how to prevent the traveling into your body. So hand hygiene. But you have to think about it in other places than normally you do. Do you use hand hygiene after you touch an elevator button? Do you use it after touching a phone when you've been standing at a crosswalk ready to go? You don't know if the person behind you has coughed and sneezed at you. So it's those kinds of things that you have to be very conscious about.
Marti, according to the statistics that I was given, 200,000 people are hospitalized from the flu-related complications each year, correct?
Absolutely.
Yeah. That's a lot of people.
It's a lot of people, but you know what is missing in that statistic is not only the hospitalization, but what's happening also beyond the hospital. So the loss of productivity, the cost that's occurred from that as far as having to treat the flu, there's so much that goes into the overall healthcare costs associated with the flu, and that you really want to encourage people to not be part of that statistic.
Okay, you told us to get our flu vaccination, wash our hands. Anything else that we can do to be proactive?
Well, one of the things is take the flu fighter quiz, but the other one that I love is use the antiviral mask. I use it when I travel. It's fantastic. It inactivates the virus, and it's just so important for you to not get sick.
Tell me about the antiviral mask just a moment. What is that?
I love this. Love this, love this. It's the Curad antiviral mask. I carry it with me wherever I go. You have to understand something. It's the only mask that's on the market that inactivates viruses. Otherwise, normal masks, if somebody coughs in your face, you will have live virus on it. It's totally made up of natural products. It's copper, zinc, and citric acid. And what that does is they're antagonistic to the cell membrane of the virus. So the virus cannot duplicate itself, so it dies. It inactivates. That's why I love this. And in other countries, they're very comfortable wearing masks. We're not as much here in the U.S. So what I do is I throw the mask on, and then I just put a scarf around it.
Great way to assimilate into society. Okay. Marti Moore is the chief nursing officer for Curet, so our information comes well qualified. Marti, where would you send my audience on the web to find out more information about preventing colds and flu?
I want them to be flu fighters, so I want them to go to Curet.com, take the quiz, and develop their own personal action plan.
Marti Moore, I thank you so very much for this information and trying to keep us healthy.
Thank you very much.